Welcome to Indian Defense News. If you are new, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when new video is uploaded.
An American soldier fires an INSAS rifle and says approvingly, "I like it, it's good." Indian Army jawans aim American rifles at targets, guided by US trainers. These are snapshots from the Yuddh Abhyas, one of the longest-running military exchanges between India and the US, this year. It's being held at the US Joint Base Lewis McChord in Washington at a time America's Defense Secretary James Mattis, a decorated war veteran and close Trump aide, is in Delhi, meeting top leaders including Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. The Yuddh Abhyas started on the 14th of September and ends tomorrow. The exercises are one of the largest running military training and defense cooperation programs between the two countries. Earlier today, Nirmala Sitharaman said, "Our military-to-military engagement continues to grow. In our talks today, we agreed to explore additional, specialized exercises." The exercises in Washington are the 13th edition of the joint event hosted alternately by the two countries. According to the Defense Ministry, the exercises provide an opportunity to the armed forces of both countries to train in an integrated manner at the battalion level with joint planning at the brigade level. The crucial Chamban-Jorian sector in southwest Jammu and Kashmir, which proved to be India's vulnerability during the 1965 and 1971 war with Pakistan, has no defenders, tanks and mechanized infantry. Top sources in the government termed the addition of tanks and mechanized infantry in Chamban-Jorian as major development. Tops Indian Army sources told India Today that the Akhnoor-based division of the Indian Army tasked to protect the Chamban-Jorian sector has been rapidized. Rapidized or Rapid Units stands for Reorganized Army Planes Infantry Divisions. In layman's language, it means addition of armored and mechanized infantry units. Sources said that the Akhnoor-based formation has been given to additional T-72 tank regiments and two mechanized infantry regiments. The Border Security Forces Operation Arjun is a measure to target residences of Inter Services Intelligence, SE, retired Pakistani Army officers and Pakistan Rangers who have been given a part of land near the Indian border. Operation Arjun is India's response to Pakistan's use of snipers to kill Indian Army soldiers and firing on civilians along the Indian border. India's measure to counter Pakistan's unprovoked firing made the latter seeking for a ceasefire, a toy report said. It also mentioned Operation Arjun particularly targets farms and residences of retired Pakistan Army, SE and Pakistan Rangers officers who have been living near the Indian border to guide the cross-border infiltration, ceasefire violations, and also providing logistical help in anti-India operations. Indian Air Force will celebrate Air Force Day on the 8th of October. Prior to this, the Air Force trainee pilots showed amazing skills while performing aerobatic in the supersonic Sukhoi 30 at Jodhpur Air Base. At the same time, the Air Force's team Garuda demonstrated the live operational activities. The updated MiG-27 and the helicopter Mi-17 pilots thrilled with their acrobatics. High-tech weapons and equipment were also exhibited on the airbase. Jodhpur Air Force Station Chief Air Commander N. Tiwari said that the Air Force celebrates Air Force Day on the 8th of October every year. Jodhpur Air Base is the most important operation air base of the western border. The trainee pilots are also trained in fighter planes here. India and the US on Tuesday agreed to boost their defense ties, with the latter willing to share some of its most advanced technologies with Asia's third largest economy. Not only does it deepen the strategic ties between the two countries, it is also seeks to counter the rapid and unpredictable rise of China and combat cross-border terrorism emanating from Pakistan. US Defense Secretary James Mattis, who is on a two-day visit to India, also discussed with Defense Minister Nirmala Sitharaman broadening maritime cooperation in the Indo-Pacific region as well as eradicating safe havens for terrorism. Mattis is the first cabinet representative from the Trump administration to visit India since the new administration took office in January. It comes after an endorsement by the Trump administration of the designation of India as a major defense partner by the previous Obama administration last year, signaling a continuity in US policy toward India. In his comments after talks with Sitharaman, Mattis said the designation of India as a major defense partner reflected the recognition of India as a pillar of regional stability and security.